the implementation cycle of our national transformation agenda. The people of Kenya require a patriotic public servant and a consummate champion of our constitutional dispensation, our broad-based national governance framework, and the bottom-up economic transformation agenda to support the cabinet and the presidency in delivering in full and on time. This moment calls for an individual who takes pride in a job well done, and is humble enough to be a loyal servant of the people, and who is selfless enough to reach out and mobilize the entirety of government towards delivering for Kenya, experienced enough to understand the importance of engaging all sectors of our economy to drive transformation, and committed enough to serve professionally with loyalty and, most importantly, with integrity. I am delighted to affirm that our coalition, and indeed our nation, is blessed with many professionals who meet all these criteria. Among them, Abraham Kithure Kindiki stands out for his exceptional qualifications, extensive experience, and wide-ranging accomplishments. I am honored that he is available. He has told me he is ready, and I know he is willing to serve as my deputy. Professor, my young brother, let me call you Abraham K. or Abra K. Welcome to the service of this great nation, Kenya. And let me say this, I have heard you clearly when you took your oath of office and the oath for the due execution of your responsibilities as Deputy President. You have said two fundamental things in your oath. Kenyans were listening. I too was listening. You said that you will serve the people of Kenya and the Republic of Kenya. Abrake, please serve the people of Kenya and the Republic of Kenya. As I told our principal secretaries, as I told our cabinet secretaries, and as I tell every public servant who has a responsibility, who has a duty, who has the honor to serve our nation, let us serve the people of Kenya and the Republic of Kenya. We are not here to serve ourselves or our families or our communities or our regions or our villages. We are here to serve the Republic of Kenya and the people of Kenya. The second thing that you have said in your oath, I said in my oath, I listened to principal secretaries and cabinet secretaries and others. You have said you will serve without fear, without favor, without affection, and without ill will. My brother Abrake, I listened to you. The people of Kenya were listening to you. Serve without bias, without ill will, without favor, without affection, and without fear. So that together, the people of Kenya can know that their public servants, all of us, elected, appointed in different categories, shall know that we have one nation, one country, one people, and we are called upon by the Constitution of Kenya to serve them without bias, without fear, without favor. And let me undertake in this very historic national ceremony to the people of Kenya. And I say this as MCAs listen to me, as members of parliament listen to me, as members of the executive listen to me, those in the judiciary, and those in the executive, that the people of Kenya, it doesn't matter, those who live near our oceans, near our lakes, in our mountains, in our valleys, in our arid and semi-arid areas, they are one people, one great nation called Kenya. And I want to commit, pledge, and undertake that we will serve the people of Kenya equally, and no part of Kenya, no community in Kenya, no section of Kenya, no region of Kenya shall be left behind. We are going to walk together. I say this to our representatives. Every MCA knows that they were never voted by all the people in their ward. Every member of parliament knows the same, that they were never voted by all the people in their constituency. And so does my friends governors. They know that not everybody in their county voted for them. But they also know that they must serve all the people, whether they voted for them or did not vote for them. Professor, you and me have the honor to serve the people of Kenya. And as I have said before, we will serve the people of Kenya equally, those who voted for us and those who did not vote for us. The government of Kenya equally belongs to all the people of the Republic of Kenya. Let me also say the following, because this is a very important occasion. To underwrite that our judiciary works, that our legislature works, and we will make sure that our executive works and serves the people of Kenya. I know that we've gone through a journey, but in this journey, we have affirmed to both ourselves as the people of Kenya, to our friends, and to the international community, we have affirmed that Kenya is a constitutional democracy founded on the firm foundation of the rule of law. We believe in freedom, and we believe in making sure that no Kenyan and none of us is left behind. Today we stand here as a people, united, peaceful, because we are a democracy.